Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyid al-Anbiya wa al-Mursaleen Amma ba'd Fa'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim Assalamu alaikum. One thing I want to remind you today is no matter how much successful you become, there's one thing that you should always take care of, and that is to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided us with so many blessings. Especially in America, we have our house, we have our cars, we have a beautiful community, we have friends, we have a family, Alhamdulillah. These are all blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And on that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even gives many great positions to many people. Alhamdulillah, some of our people are good engineers. Some of them have become doctors. Some of them have become a successful businessman. But there are some people that become arrogant. And at that point, they forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all they can say is that whatever I have achieved is through myself and no one else has helped me on it. But remember this. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives whomever He wills and He can take it from whomever He wills. تُعِزُّ مَن تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَن تَشَاءُ He can give izzat. He can give the respect to anyone and He can make anyone lose his respect. So remember that whatever you have got is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So remember Him. Remember to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This one verse from the Quran, from Surah An-Naml, tells us how the Anbiya have thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this ayat, it's regarding Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salam and Hazrat Dawood alayhi salam. Now, Hazrat Dawood alayhi salam was not born as a king, but he was a poor man. But later on, he became a king. But Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salam was born basically as a prince. And then later on, he got the kingdom. And he got a bigger kingdom than his father had. And his kingdom was such that he had power over the humans, over the jinns, over the spirits, and over the animals. If there's any king right now, he would just have power over the humans. And even in today's day, anyone that's basically in the government or any type of kingdom does not have total control upon the people. So even Sulaiman alayhi salam had this power. What does Sulaiman alayhi salam say? This ayat says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا دَاوُودَ وَسُلَيْمَانَ عِلْمًا وَقَالَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي فَضَّلَنَا عَلَىٰ كَثِيرًا مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ When we gave Dawood alayhi salam and Sulaiman alayhi salam the ilm, the wisdom, the knowledge, they said that we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has chosen us from His believing servants. So even though they are at a high rank, they remembered Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and thanked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should do the same. I make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May He give me and you the tawfiq of always remembering Him and always thanking Him whenever something good happens in our life. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khayri khalqi Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin.